Welcome to the presentation of an advanced methodology for screening of novel adsorption materials for cost-efficient CO2 capture. My name is Luca Riboldi and I am a research scientist from SINTEF Energy Research, and I will present the work on behalf of my co-authors, which are listed here. So this work has been carried out within the framework of PrISMa, which is an ACT project, where PrISMa stands for Process-informed design of tailor-made sorbent materials for energy-efficient carbon capture. For more information about the project, I would like to refer you to the presentation from the project coordinator, Susana Garcia. Also, on the right-hand side of the slide, a snapshot of the consortium, where Heriot Watt University act as project coordinator, and the other three partners are SINTEF, EPFL, and Berkeley Lab. So the motivation for this work. The motivation starts from the vision of adsorption-based processes as attractive candidates for developing cost-efficient CO2 capture solution. In this regard, there has been quite some research in recent years, where the research have been focusing mainly on material science, with the development of a very large number of novel materials like metal organic frameworks and mixed metal oxides. On the other side, we have process engineering, with several processing configurations investigated to maximize the performance. However, we noted the formation of a gap between these two domains. This is not something new for the development of a technology, but has been quite a challenge, very specifically for the development of adsorption and CO2 capture technology. PrISMa would like to bridge this gap, and then looking for synergies between material and process design in order to identify the most cost-efficient solution. With this objective in mind, PrISMa proposes an innovative approach, the first step of which is the development of a techno-economic screening tool, which allows the screening of large databases of adsorbent materials utilizing cost as a metric. This techno-economic screening tool takes elements from material science and process engineering and from several relevant case studies, where case studies are defined as combination of CO2 sources and sinks. The core element of this tool is the development of so-called screening models, which are fit-for-purpose models of pressure and temperature swing adsorption processes, which combine computational lightness with enough accurate information to perform techno-economic consideration and identification of cost for each material from the database. This will allow to identify a set of promising adsorbent material, which will be the top performing one. Whose information will be sent to the material scientists, which will deal with synthesis, characterization, and testing of the most promising candidates. Then some information will be sent back to the modeling team that through the utilization of full physical models, which are rigorous models of PSA and TSA processes, will run performance and benchmarking analysis. Some more words on the techno-economic screening tool, for which a simplified representation is shown here on the slide. This is an interdisciplinary tool, where the first part is the definition of a material database. The materials in the database will be either existing adsorbent materials, mainly metal organic framework, and in a second stage mixed metal oxide, or hypothetically built materials. For each of those, we will identify or define the physical properties that are needed in the process models, and also the pure component isotherms, which will be obtained through molecular simulation. Finally, multi-component isotherm will be predicted through the ideal adsorbed solution theory. The second element here is the definition of the case studies. So we start with the identification of a matrix of CO2 sources and sinks, and with the characterization of them. Then we combine them to form case studies which are relevant for this application. Finally, the information from the material database and from the definition of case study will be sent to the process evaluation and optimization part. This relies on the screening models of PSA and TSA processes, which integrate costing consideration in order to perform techno-economic optimization and allow for the screening of adsorbent materials based on cost. For the development of the screening models, we looked at the literature where simple thermodynamic equilibrium models have been used for material screening, also considering cost as a metric. However, the analysis based on these models necessarily relies on strong assumption, especially when calculation of cost enters the picture. For addressing these issues, we came up with a modeling development strategy that starts from these thermodynamic equilibrium models that have been modified in order to provide more accurate inputs for the costing exercise, and to which it adds layer of complexity in order to provide more and more inputs for the techno-economic analysis. The first layer of complexity is the introduction of non-ideal effects. For example, simplified approaches to introduce mass and heat transfer resistances for PSA and TSA models, or the inclusion of more realistic pressure profiles. An additional layer is layer 3, where process effects are considered, in particular a more realistic representation of process components and some consideration of on the process integration. So, in parallel, we are also developing a techno-economic analysis framework which takes the inputs from the process models and convert them into calculation of cost for allowing techno-economic optimization and screening of materials based on cost. On top of everything, there are the full physical models, rigorous models of PSA and TSA processes, which will not be used for the screening of materials because they are too computationally intensive, but rather for validation and benchmarking analysis. A key novelty of this tool is the integration of costing considerations into the process models. In order to do that, as mentioned before, we developed a TEA framework. This allows the translation of process KPIs into CAPEX and OPEX calculations. The CAPEX are calculated based on a bottom-up approach, which is shown here on the slide, while the OPEX calculations are based on utilities consumption and standard factors for maintenance and labor. So to perform the costing of the adsorption processes, a series of input parameters are needed. While in layer 3 of these process or screening models, all these parameters are made available, that is not necessarily true for the simpler layers like layer 1 and layer 2. In this case, we developed approaches that allow, in any case, to make available inputs throughout some simplifications. Finally, it is worth mentioning that the cost metric that we use for the screening is the effective carbon price, ECP. ECP is a modified CO2 avoidance cost that takes aspects of CO2 source and sink that are not usually considered in the CO2 avoidance cost calculation for material screening. These aspects are, for example, footprint, available utilities, and others. So now that the techno-economic screening tool has been presented, I would like to show a couple of illustrative examples to show the potential of it. So these examples are based on two case studies, a waste-to-energy plant and an offshore gas turbine combined cycle. We utilize an initial set of 50 adsorbent materials for the screening. 40 are existing structures that have been retrieved from different metal organic framework databases, while 10 are hypothetically built structures. This example has been carried out for pressure swing adsorption as a process, a four-step cycle process, and the results that I'm going to show are for layer 1 and layer 3 screening models. For each of these materials, techno-economic optimization has been performed utilizing the effective carbon prices objective function and as decision variables process parameters like pressure and temperature levels, for instance. Also, we implemented a series of constraints, mainly specification of CO2 recovery and purity. The optimization allows for each of these materials to identify the minimum ECP, and once this is run for all the material in the database, we obtain a series of results that allows for two types of analysis. The first one is the ranking of adsorbents, and that's what I'm going to show in the next slides, which allow the screening out of unfeasible materials, so those that are not able to meet the constraints in terms of recovery and purity, and for the remaining material to rank those to identify the most promising candidates. The other type of analysis that it is interesting, but it's not going to be shown here, is the identification of target ranges of key parameters or of material properties that allow for the design of materials that lead to cost-efficient solutions. These are the results for the waste-to-energy case study, where the ECP has been reported for each of the material in the database. The red dots are those materials that have been screened out because were not able to meet the specifications in terms of recovery or purity. The green dots did meet this specification, and the green full dots are the top performing materials that have been selected by considering a 5% margin compared to the minimum ECP that has been obtained throughout the entire database. Zooming in the feasible materials, we can see that we are able to rank those materials and identify the top performing ones. The hypothetical structures are normally performing pretty well, and that is kind of expected that because they have been ad hoc built, but we are also able to pinpoint some existing MOF that are interesting candidates for this type of application. For example, the MG MOF 74. I would like also to highlight that the layer one model seems to underpredict the ACP. That was to some extent expected because it relies on stronger approximations for the costing exercise. But on the other hand, seems also to be able to predict the same trends and to pinpoint the same top performing materials. These are the results for the offshore combined cycle case study reported in a similar fashion as the previous case study. One can immediately notice that the ECP figures are much higher in this case. This is expected as the case study is much more challenging with a lower concentration of CO2 in the feed. We are on about 3% volumetric or slightly higher. Zooming in the region of the feasible materials, we can see to be able to identify the top performing one and to rank them, which normally are the hypothetical structures, but also some existing metal organic framework, like again the NG MOF 74. With this, I reached the conclusions of my talk, where I presented a novel methodology for screening of large databases of adsorption materials for cost-effective CO2 capture. The methodology includes the definition of database of adsorbent materials, including computation of physical properties, identification of pure component isotherms by means of molecular simulation, and prediction of multi-component uptake by ideal adsorbed solution theory. Now, the key element is the development of fit-for-purpose models of PSA and TSA processes, incorporating incremental layers of complexity, and thence being suited for different screening purposes. Also, we integrated the techno-economic consideration in each of these models, and that allows for techno-economic optimization and screening of adsorbent materials based on cost. This methodology has been applied to an initial set of 50 metal organic frameworks and for two case studies. The results show that the methodology is indeed able to screen database of adsorbent materials based on the effective carbon price. Advanced models, so layer 3 type of model, provide more accurate inputs to the techno-economic analysis, but the trade-off is that the computational effort increases. Simpler models like a layer 1 type of model are much faster, but seems to be able to identify similar trends and to pinpoint the same top performing materials. However, this will need to be confirmed over wider databases. Finally, some words on the results themselves. So for the waste to energy case study, the cost figures achieved seems to suggest PSA as a competitive technology. On the other hand, for the offshore combined cycle case, the ECP obtained are pretty high, and that was quite expected, as PSA is not known to be particularly efficient for low concentration of CO2 in the feed gas. In this case, actually, TSA could be a better option. would like to conclude by acknowledging the ACT program and all the funding bodies and industrial partners in the PrISMa project, and to thank you for your attention.